I'm going to give you an honest review about my bike and my opinion and what are the pros and cons of the bike and whether you should go for it in 2018, yes or no. Also, I'm going to take you what are the expenditures that you are going to be facing on the bike. So let's get started with the video. I purchased my motorcycle in 2015 September and it's been 2.5 years since then. I'm not gonna show you how many kilometers I've done. So let's start off with the problems. So the problem number one is the front forks and the seat. Now because it's an upside down forks, so this has a stiff riding position in the front end, and because the seat is also hard, so combining both, the ride quality on this bike is very, very pathetic. I mean, if you're riding in bad roads and if you're riding in the city, then it's gonna be very, you are gonna be getting a very hard time. But the rear suspension, this part, this is very soft, so pillion is gonna be comfortable and the rider is gonna be very uncomfortable, by the way, in the cities. So the problem number two is the heating of the bike. Well, this bike is not meant to ride in the city, as I mentioned before. And if you're riding wearing shorts, then you're gonna seriously face some third degree burns on your legs. So as you guys know that KTM is a wonderful machine, it's a very good machine, but its one problem is that you have to put koi na koi kharcha chota chota deta rehta hai. So ye cheez hai, ye Bajaj ke sath bhi hai, KTM ke sath bhi hai, aur sports bike loge to usually aapko kharcha aata hi hai. So mujhe bhi aisa aaya hai kharcha jo main abhi expenditure mein dalne wala hu. Ye dekh ke aapko kya lag raha hai? Well, ये MRF के tyres हैं and this comes stock with the bike and that's the reason why the ride quality on this bike is not good when it comes to the stock tyres and I have replaced the tyres. The next part is the headlight. Well, because it's a halogen bulb, so it's not good in nights. Usually I don't do night ride, but still the light beam is not good and this is one of the problems that I face usually. Part of the video is the modifications that I have done on the bike to make it more better. So the first visible modification is the visor, because I tour sometimes and I also mostly hit the highway, so I need a good visor. So this is the custom visor from Vietnam. This is also a universal visor, by the way, but this is mainly for Duke 200 and 390. So I've got this for about 1200 rupees. Then, as I mentioned before, the headlights is not good. So I changed this headlight to a Philips Extreme Vision, which is a little better, but this is also not that better. LED lights are much better, but this is doing the job. Then I've got my name, the YouTube name. If you can see at my visor, I've got the India flag. Then I've got rim stickers, if you can see. Now the bike is dirty, so it's little off, sorry for that. So I've got some rim stickers. This is all custom made by me. I made these stickers because this part of the fork, because I do a lot of trail riding, so this becomes a lot dirty and it's very irritating to clean it off. So that's the reason why I got the stickers. And if you can see this, these are known as fork sleeves, which is also made by me, DIY. This is a DIY. This is the laptop sleeve, by the way, and these are the Velcro straps. And combining both of this and going to a tailor, I have made the front fork sleeve. Because as you all guys know, because it's an upside down forks and we live in India. The next modification that I have done on the bike is the cap. I've changed the cap, the brake oil cap, because the initial cap was not that good. It was a little plasticky, so I did not like it. So I went for a metal cap. So I've got the Oogie sticker on me. He's also a good friend of mine. Then my blood group is A positive, so unfortunately, I know it will not happen, but if someday if I crash and if I need blood, then somebody can look at this and can help me out. And I'll also suggest you guys to put this on your bike as well, whichever blood group you have. Next part is the tires. So as I mentioned that the stock tires, the MRF, they don't provide a lot of grip. So I changed the tires to Metzeler's initially. Then the video is online. You can watch that video as well. And then that tire got wear out, so I went for Michelin's. Now, this is also a very good tire, guys. But the problem with Michelin's is, because this tire is a hard compound tire, so this will give you better life and good grip as well. But in wet conditions, this is not good. This is not the tire to go for. This slips a little bit on the wet conditions. And also, because this tire is hard compound, this is a little heavy. So I have seen a drop of mileage on my bike. Initially in the city I used to get 25 to 27 in the city, and on the highway I used to get about 30 to 35. The maximum amount of mileage that I have got on my bike is about 338 in a full tank. So that's the maximum mileage that I have got.
But the name over here and the number plate as well.
Then yeah, the biggest modification that I have not shown you, if you see my tire, the rim, this is not the rim from the 2017 Duke 200. This is basically the RC 390 rim which I have got. And I have not painted this rim. This is the rim I have swapped from the RC 390 to my bike. Another thing from RC 390 are the foot pegs. I have got the foot pegs to an RC 390 foot pegs because they have a little better grip, by the way. Then whenever I go on the racetrack, I change the air filter to a K&N air filter. Right now I am not going on the racetrack as well. Also, I change the engine oil to a Motul 300V when I go on the racetrack, but usually I ride on the highway, so it's not much of the need. But I've got this grip, tank grip. This is not useful, guys, but because due to your riding jacket, you will tend to scratch the tank. That is the reason why I bought this. I know this looks a little ugly, but what you can do, you have to maintain the bike. Let's talk about the expense on the bike. How you can afford a Duke 200? Complete service will cost you about 3,500, and I think that is very minimum because on the 390 the service cost is the same, and due to GST. Now the problems that I have faced, well, I have replaced the magnetic coil once and that costed me about 2,000 rupees. Why the magnetic coil burns? Whenever we start the motorcycle in the morning or once a day, we have to let it on for a minute. We should not rev the bike. And if you just start riding the bike, then the magnetic coil starts burning. That is a very common problem on the KTM Duke 200 because we don't have a kick and all. Then the next problem is that I have replaced the battery as well on the bike. I went for the same Exide battery, which has a 2 years warranty. So that costed me about 2,000 rupees again. Then the tires that I mentioned, the Metzeler's costed me 10,000 and now the Michelin's costed me about 6,000. The rim stickers costed me about 700 rupees.
Also change your clutch cable and accelerator cable every 5,000 kilometers.
The fork sleeve costed me about 350 rupees. And the majority stickers they have overall costed me about 1,500. These are the basic expenditures that I've done on the bike. These are the stock levers. Well, I had maxi levers on this which costed me 550 rupees, but those levers were giving me a hard time. Apart from this, minor problems, a few parts here and there, those have costed me around 2,000 in 2.5 years. And I always service my bike in every 7,500 kilometers, but I change my engine oil in every 5,000 kilometers. Every 15,000 kilometers, you have to change both the tires, which will cost you a good 10,000 rupees. Then you have to change the chain sprocket, which will cost you about 3,500. Then at least you have to do two services, which will cost you about 7,000. So all in all, you are going to be spending a good 20 to 21,000 rupees for every 15,000 kilometers. And I think that's all right. That is how you have to maintain the bike. And one thing that I forgot to mention, get a radiator cover because there are very bad roads in Indian conditions. Because we ride in Indian conditions, we have to face bad roads every day. So anything can go inside and can, you know, leak the radiator. So make sure you get a radiator cover, which I have not got, but I would suggest you guys, these are the things that I have seen. Also, if you do a lot of off-roading like me, then you have to go for dash plate or skid plate, that is known, which is aluminium or a metal plate, which I have to purchase from Sayadri, but time malum hai tum logo ko, main late videos dalta hu. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you have got some knowledge, whatever you wanted, and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. And I hope I put these videos